In this video, we're going to be introduced to the idea of a linearization. But first, let's just consider this function, f of x equals x squared plus 2, and all we're asked to do is find the equation of the tangent line to that curve at the point 1, 3. So I need to take a derivative to find my slope, and then we'll use this point to be able to find the equation of that tangent line. Well, pretty easy derivative to work with. F prime of x is equal to 2x. And I know when I plug 1 into the function, I get out 3. And the slope of the tangent line I'm looking for will be f prime of 1, which is 2. So I'm looking for the equation of a line with a slope of 2 that passes through the point 1, 3. So let's see, my tangent line. I can just use point slope. And here's my tangent line. Y equals 2x plus 1. Well, my tangent line goes through that point. I see the y-intercept's 1, so I think my tangent line would look something like this. And let's look at it in a little more detail. I'm going to use my graphing calculator. And I've already graphed y equals x squared plus 2 in my graphing calculator. Let's just add in the graph of y equals 2x plus 1. Hit the graph button, and there I see the two graphs together. A little bit of shadow there, and I see my tangent line comes up and hits the parabola right in that spot. I want to zoom in on the point 1, 3, or at least close to it. So I'll try to zoom in right on that spot by hitting zoom and then moving my cursor with the arrow keys until I'm around the point 1, 3, and that seems pretty close. So I zoom in, just looking a little bit closer, and I see that again, my tangent line comes and hits my function. Let's zoom in again and look at the two pictures together, even zoomed in closer. And again, I'm just gonna leave my cursor really close to 1, 3, a little piece of the parabola. There's my line. And what I see as I zoom in is the two graphs are almost indistinguishable near the point of tangency 1, 3. In fact, if I zoom in one more time, it's hard to even tell the two graphs apart. Near the point where they touch, that point 1, 3, the two graphs look like each other. In fact, that's actually what we mean by the linearization of a function at a point. At x equals 1, this line behaves a lot like the graph of y equals x squared plus 2. For that reason, the tangent line at x equals a is also known as the linearization linearization of f of x centered at x equals a, with the idea being if I want to replace the graph of my function near that value of x with a function that was easier to deal with, I would use the equation of this line. We also call the linearization the standard linear approximation of f of x centered at a. One of the points I want to make is that if someone asks you to find a linearization of a function or asks you for a standard linear approximation, all you are doing is finding the equation of a tangent line. And that's a skill we already have. The only difference is most of the time if we tell someone a linearization, instead of saying y equals, we write L of x equals. The linearization of x is 2x plus 1. But every time someone asks you for a linearization, I want you to remind yourself you're looking for the equation of a tangent line. Now, in your textbook, you'll see a formula for the linearization. And I want to talk about that formula. So we have a function f of x and that function is defined at a And f prime of a exists. Then the linearization of f of x centered at a is, and what I want to do is I want to fill in a formula here for L of x, right? I want to write it down in symbols. Now in practice, I'm just going to find the equation of a tangent line, but I want to talk about that formula that's in the textbook. Well, if I think about finding the equation of a tangent line, I generally use point slope. And if I just fill in all the spots with the idea of a tangent line, I'll know what to write down here for this formula. So x1, well, that's the value of a. Y1, well, that's the point on the curve that corresponds to a, so that would be f of a. So right away, I'm using the point a comma f of a. Just like on the example before, I was using 1 comma 3, right? A comma f of a. The slope, well, that comes from the first derivative evaluated at a. So what I wanted to write down, what I want to do is write down what all of this says using a, f of a, and f prime of a in the places where they go. Just like I was finding the equation of a tangent line. So I'd have y minus f of a equals f prime of a times x minus a. And if I get y by itself and do nothing else, just get y by itself, I would have y equals, and add f of a to both sides. So f of a plus f prime of a times x minus a. That would give me my linearization. That would be the equation of my tangent line. Now, when I actually write them down, I distribute and collect like terms and give someone a line and slope intercept form. But I can come back here and say this is a formula that would give you a linearization. And so this is a formula for linearization you will see in your textbook. But what I want you to remember, every time someone asks you to find a linearization, means that all you have to do is find the equation of a tangent line. So we have a new idea that we can approximate a function with a linear function, the tangent line, call it the linearization, but we're really just practicing that skill of finding the equation of a tangent line.